Hello, this is old Mr. Kent of MrKent.com, and I should have made this video yesterday because there was a lot more smoke in the air. In fact, yesterday you could see the sun and it was dark orange because of all the smoke. And today there's a little less smoke, but you can see the outline of the mountains in the distance. Yesterday you couldn't see the mountains. So I should have made this yesterday, and I have to apologize for the lack of brightness in the video, because no matter what time of day I would have taken this video, it just doesn't get very bright because of the thickness of the air, because of smoke from the wildfires. All the western states, starting I guess over as far east as South Dakota, visibility and air quality is just really bad. So here yesterday when we looked out at Superstition Mountain, you couldn't see it. So it is getting better, but anyway, I thought, well, I'm gonna shoot a video of what's going on here and show you some smoke in the air. And by the way, the construction project, making the little addition to the shop, to my son's shop for my wife and I. If you haven't been following my videos, he invited us to move out to his place and live in a fifth wheel, and then he's building a little additional storage shop for my wife and I. And we had a terrible windstorm and it ripped off the roof, ran water down into the freshly drywall. But fortunately, the drywall guy that came in to fix things said that because it was a vaulted ceiling, because it followed the contour of the roof on top, water didn't stand. It just ran off. And so as soon as it quit raining and the temperatures came up to 110, 115, everything pretty much evaporated. And so there's no permanent damage. And of course, there was a few things that needed to be repaired, but that's all fixed. So anyway, I thought, well, I'll just fly around the neighborhood. I haven't flown around this way before, and maybe tell a story or two. Oh, and by the way, one of the things I used to teach the kids in school, you know, when you were in school in science class, they said, well, the raindrops come because the moisture in the air condenses on a dust particle up in the sky. And of course, all the dust particles I'm familiar with here in Arizona don't go up. They end up landing on everything. But the miracle of this is that because of all this smoke in the air, smoke, when you see smoke coming up from a forest fire, looks really thick, then it thins out, and all of this smoke that's in the air is made up of decomposing wood particles, and so you could call those dust particles, and they will go up with this. They go up. Smoke always goes up, and so it goes up into the sky, and eventually all these dust particles are going to turn into raindrops. And the cool thing is when it's really hot and you don't have much rain, and it's like we're having a hot spell now, it's because there aren't any clouds. And so what's happening here is we're having dry lightning. It causes fires, and the fires create smoke, and the smoke goes up in the sky, and then eventually that smoke turns into raindrops and snowflakes, which then fall on the mountains and create rivers for us for water to drink, and then it also turns into clouds and rains on the forests and dry land. And that creates a balance, and now there's no dry lightning and no fires, and you don't have these hot spells. Maybe next year it won't be quite so hot because there's more dust in the air and more clouds are created. So that's kind of cool how that works. We have a wonderful God who designed all of this stuff just for us. All right, so I promised that I would tell a story about flying in the rain, and I'm going to run out of time here if I don't get started. So let me tell you about the most dangerous time I ever flew in the rain. You wouldn't think it was dangerous, at least I didn't when I took off to fly that day. What I had to do is fly from Pasco, Washington, fly south, which was only about 30 or 40 miles, to Hermiston, Oregon, where there was where my aircraft mechanic had his hangar, and I needed to fly down there for something. And it was winter time, and it was raining. And there's a range of mountains called the Saddle Mountains that go along the Columbia River in between Pasco and Hermiston. But those mountains, that little range, is Pasco's altitude above sea level is only 400. And the range of mountains is only like 15, 16, 1800. So it's not that much of a great climb or anything. And I just flew over those without thinking every time I needed to go down to see my my aircraft mechanic. So it was a winter morning and it was raining, and but I wanted to fly down there, and I didn't pay attention to what the temperature was. I just needed to fly down to see my mechanic. So I get in my plane at the Pasco airport and contact the tower and take off and start heading south. And I just gradually climb as I'm going towards the Saddle Mountains. And as I'm climbing along, I'm getting higher and higher. And finally, I got up to about, probably over 2,000 feet. And I came to the mountains. Now, the mountains, they have a little bit of width to them also, not just height. So I got up there, and I was just starting to go over the mountains. Of course, remember now, it's raining. And it's raining so hard that it's hard to see out the front, but you can see out the back. And as I'm flying along, because I went up to a higher altitude, the air got cooler. And so now the rain is not rain. It's freezing rain. And it's starting to accumulate on my windshield. And now I'm, what would you call it, committed over the mountains. And so I thought, well, I can still see out the side windows. And it was getting more and more difficult to see out the front. And then all of a sudden it dawned on me, all this ice that was forming on the windshield was also forming on the front edge of the wings. And when you get ice on the front edge of your wings, it ruins the lift, and that's why planes crash. And so I got as close as I could to the sagebrush as I came down and came over those mountains, and was just, 50 feet over the sagebrush, got as low as I could, looking out the side of the window, side window, and eventually got down low enough where the ice started to dissipate off of my windshield. So if I had to remain at that altitude, eventually I would not have, my plane would have just gone down. So that's my flying in the rain story for today. I got more of those stupid things I did. Check the temperature before you take off your airplane if it's raining outside. All right. Well, I want to thank you for watching the video and putting up with my stories. And God bless.